on. End of the kingdom. But watch what you bring home. You see a black man with a white woman at the top floor, they gon' come to kill King Kong. Middle America packed in. Can't see me in my black skin. Number one question they asking. Fucking be question you asking. If I don't get ran out by Catholics, it comes to conservative Baptists. Claiming I'm overreacting like the black kids in Chirac, bitch. 4 in the morning, and I'm zoning. They say I'm possessed. It's the omen. I keep it 300, like the Romans. 300 bitches with the Trojans. Baby, we living in the moment. I've been a menace for the longest.
Oh, I'm coming. Sorry, everybody. Come on, gorgeous. How is everyone? Yay! Guys, honestly, it's so amazing for me to be here. I love coming up to Newcastle, honestly. Does everyone know who I am? You in the right place? Woo! Okay, so my name's Jamie Stevens. I'm the global ambassador, one of the global ambassadors for Matrix Haircare. So very fortunate. I'm not lucky, because the harder we work, the luckier we get. But very fortunate with my job that I get to travel all around the world and doing things like this, hopefully passing on some bits for you guys that you can take back to your salons, hopefully make you better hairdressers, hopefully make you more money. So just want to start by saying a massive thank you to BL Hairdressing for obviously getting me here today. So thank you very much. And obviously, as always, the support of Matrix for making this possible. There's lots of teams that have behind helped me today. So what are you going to see from me? I will stop talking. You will see some hair, I promise. But I've kind of broken it down into 3 sections. So we're going to do some sort of cuts, talking about some colours. And then we've got some men, a few ladies, or men, if you like that sort of thing. And then we've got a bit of avant-garde. What you're not going to see is you're not going to see any haircuts from start to finish. You're just going to see like the juicy bits, just so I can cram some bits in. So I spin this beautiful model around. You can firstly see the color. Okay, so what I've actually done is I've gone in and hands up people who calls that an undercut. Yeah, so most hairdressers call an undercut. An undercut originally was invented as a removal of weight. But normally what happens, I don't know if any of you notice this, but when you say the word undercut in a salon in front of your client, it petrifies them. So what we're kind of doing is, this is a haircut that we've actually been sort of working with in the salon, okay? And what we're calling this now is like a collapsed layer rather than an undercut, because obviously when you take the hair shorter underneath, the layer on the top collapses. So it's just a softer way of saying undercut. We're lying really, but it just makes us sound better. And with this, technically, it's an inverted bob, okay? Looks really technical, but actually what I've done is I've taken a section, kind of just below the recession area, and I've cut. Are you laughing at me? Did I miss something then? Okay. You drunk? Right, I'll start again. So, pre-cut all the section through the underneath, starting from the recession area, just below what we call the parietal ridge, okay? And if people don't know, the parietal ridge is the furthest part of where your skull sits out. Everyone's will be different. Best way, put a comb flat to your head. When the comb starts to bend, that's the furthest point. Okay, so straight all the way around. And then this section, if I turn it through the back, okay, all I've done is the whole hair is then just been combed straight back and over directing it into the middle and cut on the same baseline as through the back. Okay, but naturally, then when it drops forward, it will perfectly go from long to short. But just with having that shortness underneath, how many people have clients that say, I want to change, but I don't want any haircut off? Something like this is perfect, because what you can do is you can tuck this behind your ear, still get this beautiful slope, but you just have then an element of difference. And with the color, all we've done is actually just split it into quadrants, okay? We at Matrix try not to use the word hot cross bun anymore, because so food. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through and I'm going to use... Can everyone see these? Okay. Right. Hands up who calls them texturizers. Hands up who calls them thinning scissors. Okay. If anyone called them thinning scissors, you work for me, you'd be gone. So the word thinning petrifies people. So we call them texturizers. Okay. This technique is not for everyone. So if you like it, use it. If you don't, don't. But it's such an amazing way to create internal texture without losing any length, okay? So I just drop a head forward. I'm coming in and I'm actually using my hands effectively if it was my comb. And I'm not fully, if I do it slowly, I'm kind of coming up and out. And I'm only using like the end of the scissor, not in here, which is what we call the heel. Because actually on a pair of texturizers, the heel is a scissor. So if you close too close to the heel, you'll cut the hair off, okay? So just in, and it's more of like a pinching motion. So never fully closing. Okay, you'll start to see all this hair falling in my tray, which I don't want. So I take loads of inspiration, you know, lots of people ask me, where do I get my inspiration from? It's very simple, everywhere, literally. I love educating, love working with different hairdressers of different levels, because, you know, just the simplest thing of when you show someone something and they make a mistake, that sometimes in my head is like one of the most incredible ideas ever. So you can see, even though all of this hair is coming off, I'm not actually taking anything off the base. So when all it will start to do is it actually doing that quadrant color, you'll start to see however I move, it just instantly takes a one length haircut into something softer. Okay, so anything that I always say to people, if there's something you've seen which you've never done, my biggest advice is practice on a dolly head, okay? Because if you get it wrong, she can't complain. And even though I'm up here and I'm doing it quite fast, slowly, slowly wins the race, okay? So never go straight in with anything fast when you don't have that much experience into it. Okay. And again, she had a really strong, beautiful, sort of low nape swirl neckline. Anything like that, if I'm working with, say something with aggression, I'll always work with it because it actually grows out better. So can you just see how that's starting to now sort of shatter everything internally and just makes it look completely softer? So something very strong to soft internal texture. If anyone's sitting there thinking, would I do this every haircut on my client? Absolutely not, because after two visits, you're gonna have no hair left. So this is something I would only ever do every couple. And then what I'm gonna do is just with the fringe, I don't know if you guys have noticing here, are you noticing that fringes are come away from very blunt to very choppy? Yeah? Well, that's what I'm gonna do with this. And again, I'm actually gonna use my texturizers, going in what we call very shallow point cutting, but just with my texturizers. Go in slightly deep, and then just pull it down. So it still actually gives you the solid outline, but it just makes it slightly easier when you want to separate. If anyone wants to know about what colors, because obviously it's a long old process to sit here and talk about all the colors, And I'm not going to lie, I do love colouring, but I don't really do it, and the guy's back here. So we will make some notes, and if you want to speak to your local rep or come and see us later, we're sure we're going to be hanging around somewhere, then we can tell you about all the colours. Okay, and all I'm going to do, just to finish off, just go through, blast it, get rid of that excess hair. So the great thing I love about playing with different sections of colour is never does she have to look the same. Okay, so she parts her hair over on that side, she exposes the light, she drops that over on the other side, it reveals a completely different look. So I'm all about sort of multi-tones, multi-texture, but mainly sort of for clients, choices. So just to finish off, gonna put a bit of the Stylelink shape switcher. Really good tip for you when you're teaching clients how to apply product. Too many hairdressers, one, overload, okay? Biggest tip, put it in the palm of your hand. All hairdressers do this, okay? And then they go straight in. Normally what happens when you just do this, you're putting nearly 100% of that product straight there. So my tip is I distribute the product front and back and in between my fingers. So then no matter what part of my hand touches the hair, you get even distribution and you don't get overload. Okay, so kind of mainly working not too much through the root area. And then we're gonna keep it quite sexy. Tiny bit of hairspray. Everyone, this is Alex, by the way. Let's give Alex a little round of applause. Hey. Oh, so did you just get a whistle? I never got a whistle. Yes, that's better. Thank you very much. Right, guys, so quick recap. Undercut, which is now what we call a collapsed layer. Box bob, sort of hugging the jaw just to the cheekbones. Everything coming back to that baseline. Club cut, so then you get that drop down of the extended length. And then just gone in complete freehand with a pair of what? Well done. Right, there we go. That's the first one. Hope you like it.